Today, let's check out brand new features that Microsoft just introduced for Teams. If you're using Teams on a regular basis, you're going to find these helpful. Number one, expanded emoji picker. The emoji update comes with a wide range of emojis to Teams. So instead of just 85, you now get over 800 choices. There is a category selector, like for example, smileys, people, animals, food, and so on. Now, some of these are animated, like for example, these, and some aren't animated. You also get a skin tone selector for some of these emojis. The ones that have that option have this dot on the top right-hand corner. When you right-click, you can select the skin tone you want to use. Your choice is then going to be saved for that login session. In pop-up chats and meetings, you also have the ability to use a short code. So let's go to chat, let's pop this out, and let's say I'm looking for a special emoji, I'm just going to open the bracket, put in TIR for tired, I get a list here, I can use my keyboard keys and then tab to select the one that I want. The expanded emoji picker is now available on Microsoft Teams on desktop and the web. For mobile, it's going to come later. Number two, new content sharing tray. Microsoft also updated the user experience for sharing content during a meeting. The new share tray now makes it easier to find what you're looking for. It's up here instead of down on the bottom. Select screen to share your entire screen. Select the window tile to see a list of all the windows that you have open. Just select one of the windows and start sharing. To go back to the main screen, click on this back arrow here. Use PowerPoint Live to share a PowerPoint file using the new and improved sharing experience. You can select the file from the most recently used files. If you don't see the file that you're looking for, browse OneDrive or browse your computer to upload the file. Select Microsoft Whiteboard if you want to share a whiteboard in your meeting. Also, if you want to share the system audio, make sure you include computer sound. So for example, if you're going to YouTube and you want to play a video, turn this on so that your audience can hear it. So basically, the new share tray allows you to share everything you could in the old share tray, but now it's better organized and less cluttered. Number three, out of office status. With the out of office status in Teams, you can now let others know that you're currently not working or on vacation. Now, Teams is going to automatically take over the status from Outlook. So if you turn on automatic replies in Outlook by going to File, Automatic Replies, let's quickly turn this on and click on OK. Automatic replies are now turned on for Outlook. I'm going to go back to Teams. I get this new icon here, and when I click on my profile, it says out of office, and I can see the same status I have in Outlook. If I turn it off in Outlook, it's going to turn it off in Teams as well. This is really convenient. You can also set it up yourself directly in Teams. Click on Set Status Message. On the bottom here, you see Schedule Out of Office. Just select that, and you can turn on automatic replies here. Number four, automatic attendance list after a meeting. In the old days, you had to download the meeting attendance list at some point during the meeting. You couldn't get the list once the meeting was over. Now you don't have to worry about this because the attendance list is automatically created and posted to the channel once the meeting is over. When you click on this, it's going to open the file in Excel. Number five, live reactions. Use live reactions to make your meetings more engaging. Just hover over Show Reactions, and you can now send a thumbs up, a heart, applause, or laughter to share your reactions with others. It's a nice addition to make meetings more interactive and keep the chat box from filling up too quickly. So these are some of the new features that are currently rolled out in Teams. If you don't see a specific feature right now, you might just have to wait a bit until it's fully available. I hope you're going to find these useful. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you did, and consider subscribing if you haven't already done so. Many thanks for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.